I would request all the participants to kindly mute your audio, and only Dr. Kare, the audio will be functional. Requested all the participants to kindly mute your audio. Thank you. On behalf of CMDC, we would like to welcome you all once again for a webinar on a very good topic, which is on diabetic and related lifestyle modifications. And I welcome all the participants to this webinar on behalf of RCF and CMDC. I would like to invite our today's faculty, a very eminent doctor, all the way from Pune, Dr. Shailaja Kare. A very warm welcome to you, Dr. Kare. Speaking about today's topic, if you speak about diabetics, it's basically a very complex disease which has affected a lot of people, not only in India, but worldwide. And the best part is, if we adapt to a very healthy lifestyle, we can manage the diabetics and prevent this illness. So getting an awareness about this pre-diabetic conditions and diabetes is very important to consider, and making a change in the lifestyle is of utmost importance. CMDC always endeavors to provide inputs and learnings and knowledge in areas which is of immense help to the employees in order to enhance their productivity at work. So this is a topic which actually is very close to the heart, which affects the health. And the best part is, if there is quite a lot of knowledge and awareness about this health issue, it can be prevented or it can be avoided. So we thought of conducting this program or this webinar on this issue on diabetes. And we have a very eminent faculty, which is Dr. Shailaja Kare. Before I welcome her to this session, I would brief her about her credentials. Dr. Shailaja Kare is an MD in medicine, an MD again in FRCP from London. She's a professor in internal medicine in the King Edward Memorial Hospital, Pune. She's a consultant diabetes unit at the King Edward Memorial Hospital, Pune. She's also a research associate with the hospital. She's the director of the Directors Kare's Diabetes and Specialty Clinics. Again, a director at the Euro-Asian Academy of Clinical Diabetology. And also, again, a director at the Orange Diabetes Medical Foundation and Research Center, Pune. She's a chairman at the RSSDI Maharashtra chapter, and also a member in the advisory board diabetes in the Pregnancy Group of India. She has lot many awards to her credit, which is the Punya Parvati Bhushan, Dr. Anandi Joshi Award, the Zee National Healthcare Award, the Maharashtra Times Health Icon Award, the Felicitated at Trinity College, Dublin at the Centenary 300-Year Diabetes Program. She also has lot of research work to her credit, which is on diabetes and pregnancy, genetics of type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular risk in type 2 diabetes, and she has conducted more than 100 patient education program in the last 30 years. And she's published Notice Diabetes books and a DVD with Sakal Group of Papers. So with this credentials and with such kind of contribution to this field, I once again welcome Dr. Kare and request you to take the session, please. Yes, ma'am.
I'm audible, I think.
Yes. Right?
Okay, thank you so much. And I'm quite thankful to have a dialogue with all of you. I can see many people have joined, so looks like many people are interested in this topic. And I immensely thank your organization, not just for calling me, but having this plan of education in the health department, which is so crucial. And Mr. Sonone, I know that थोडंसं मराठी मध्ये बोलते, कारण गेले 20-25 वर्ष वी नो इच अदर. हिज फॅमिली आय नो व्हेरी वेल, अँड ही मस्ट हॅव गॉन थ्रू दीज काइंड ऑफ प्रोग्राम्स अँड मस्ट बी नोईंग दिस. सो कॉन्ग्रॅच्युलेशन फॉर दिस आयडिया ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग इन हेल्थ रिलेटेड काइंड ऑफ अ गायडन्स, अँड थँक्स अ लॉट. सो आय थिंक आय विल स्टार्ट विथ माय लेक्चर. सो Can I share my screen now? I think so. You are already given me. So, can you see my slides? Can you see my slides? You are muted, so I can't hear you.
Oh, yes, ma'am, we can see the slides.
Yeah. Okay, perfect. So, today I will be speaking a bit in, I think the chat box is open, no? So, if I want to know if someone wants to say something, but I will be speaking in Marathi and Hindi and English. So, is it okay? Do you want everything in Marathi, Hindi? That's fine, no? So, I think let's start that. What is this diabetes related? So, now when we say we have these lifestyle diseases, which we say diabetes, blood pressure, heart problems, and we call them as a Jeevan Shaili Se Azar, Adhunik Jeevan Shaili Se Azar, or maybe lifestyle diseases. So, why this happens? Our ancestors of hunter-gatherer time, they never had these problems. Their vessels were as clean, ekdam swachha, without any kind of a damage to the blood vessels. So these lifestyle diseases, diabetes, blood pressure, heart disease, all are actually diseases of our blood vessels. And why it was not there when our hunter-gatherer society was there? So these people, when they were doing hunting, before they went to agricultural and industrial revolution, actually, so you can see that they never had diabetes or blood pressure. So आता समजा आपल्याला त्यांचा अभ्यास करायचा असेल तर आपण अनेक million years मागे जाऊन तर त्यांना तपासू शकत नाही की काय बरं असं होतं या लोकांच्या शरीरामध्ये की त्यांना हे आजार नाही झाले किंवा व्हॉट वॉज देअर ट्रिक. सो पण देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी बिकॉज देर इज अ पॉप्युलेशन जे राहतात अमेझॉनच्या खोरं म्हणतो आपण तसं साऊथ अमेरिकेमध्ये आणि यांना म्हणतात सिमने पीपल. आणि या लोकांमध्ये तुम्ही जर बघितलं तर त्यांच्यामध्ये रक्तवाहिन्या खराब व्हायचं प्रमाण हे कित्येक पट आपल्यापेक्षा कमी आहे. ही एक आदिवासी लोकांची जमात आहे विच आर स्टेईंग इन बोलिव्हियन अमेझॉन अँड दे डू नॉट हॅव दीज डिसीजेस. सो देर वॉज एन अपॉर्च्युनिटी टू स्टडी दीज पीपल दॅट व्हॉट इज द डिफरन्स बिटवीन देम अँड अस. सो हाऊ अवर हंटर गॅदरर पर्सन वॉज डुईंग अँड व्हॉट इज द डिफरन्स नाव विच वी आर डुईंग दॅट वी हॅव दीज प्रॉब्लेम्स. सो देर वॉज अ स्टडी पब्लिश्ड ऍक्च्युली इन अवर सायंटिफिक जर्नल्स विच टेल अस दॅट दीज पीपल सिमने ट्राईब whose blood vessels are absolutely clean, they do not. The only difference, two difference, one is extremely physically active lifestyle. Extremely physically active lifestyle throughout the day. There is a difference between ek ghanta exercise karo din mein aur pura din baithe raho. Bahut achha exercise karo ek ghanta, but whole day you are sitting. And you do 1 hour exercise and whole day you are active. There is a difference in that. So these people are physically active throughout the day. The difference was if there is a daytime, they just, their clock is according to the sun. It's not like us. So whenever there is a sunset, there is no electricity there. Sunset, they sleep. When they wake up at the sunrise, throughout the day, only 1% or 10% of their time they are sitting. That time also they are parenting or eating. For us, 60% of the time we are sitting, mostly. If you are on computer, you are 100% time sitting. Another difference was extremely healthy lifestyle and subsistence diet. What is subsistence diet? I think everyone knows this because of the lockdown. We don't need to eat much. If we don't go out for 8 days to buy vegetables or anything, we can sustain. So we actually need very little amount of food to sustain. We don't need so much of variety that we all have experienced in this lockdown period. So I feel we got this learning what our ancestors or these Simane tribal people were doing and why they do not have blood pressure, diabetes and heart disease. So It's a great learning. It's a published paper in our scientific journal. And there are a lot of things we can learn from these wonderful people, what they are doing, and we can change. So let's see that what wrong things we are doing. So we all know why we discuss diabetes, because say diabetes, India is the capital of diabetes. So what is happening in India? Why people are saying ki India is the maximum problem? So there is a more number of people in India. The way diabetes is rising in other countries, it is rising very fast in India. There is one more thing. I don't know, whatever people who have joined today, jevde doko tumhi join zalela ahat, tyatla mala sagle jaast kautuk asha lokancha karaycha aahe ki jyanna diabetes nahi aahe आणि तरी पण तुम्ही हे माझा लेक्चर ऐकताय त्यांना 100 पैकी 110 मार्क 100 पैकी 100 मार्क बिकॉज त्यांच्यासाठी हे जास्त महत्त्वाचं आहे ज्यांना डायबिटीस आहे त्यांनी तर ऐकायलाच पाहिजे पण डायबिटीस नसताना सुद्धा ज्यांनी जर तपासलं नसेल तर समाजामध्ये अनेक लोकांना डायबिटीस असू शकतो सो हे जर आपल्याला माहिती असेल तर आपण जरी म्हटलं की आपल्याकडे खूप प्रॉब्लेम आहेत तरी तेवढेच लोक डायबिटीस निदान न झालेले पण आहेत आता आपल्या देशापुढचे प्रॉब्लेम्स काय आहेत तर जेव्हा आपण म्हणतो भारतासारख्या देशापुढे विच इज अ डेव्हलपिंग कंट्री इन्फेक्शियस डिसीज याच्याबद्दल तर सध्या तर मी कोविडच्या काळामध्ये काही बोलू शकत नाही बट त्याच्यापूर्वी सुद्धा मेनली कॉलरा टायफॉइड टीबी माल न्यूट्रिशन पॉवर्टी यू आर इन द ऍग्रिकल्चर इंडस्ट्री तुम्ही सगळे लोक तर तुम्हाला हे यु नो ऑल दिस थिंग्स आणि देर आर मी तुम्हाला ऍग्रिकल्चर बद्दल सांगते माझे सासरे वॉज द ही वॉज व्हाईस चान्सलर ऑफ राहुरी कृषी विद्यापीठ अँड ही हॅज लॉट ऑफ स्टुडंट सायंटिस्ट की ज्यांना मी पण मदत करते आता की दे आर ट्राईंग टू डू तुमचं जे क्रॉप असतं म्हणजे ज्वारी बाजरी याच्यामधलं आयर्न कंटेंट कसं सुधारेल याच्यामधलं व्हिटॅमिन कंटेंट कसं सुधारेल आणि याच्यासाठी खूप रिसर्च चालू आहे राईस मधलं व्हाईट कार्बोहायड्रेट कसं कमी होईल हे आजकाल अनेक ठिकाणी रिसर्च असतं विच इज रिलेटेड टू युअर फील्ड विच इज अ ग्रेट थिंग इफ वी हॅव अ गुड फूड राईट ॲट दॅट स्टेज तर बऱ्याचशा गोष्टी आपल्याला सोप्या होणार आहेत सो या सगळ्या गडबडीमध्ये डेव्हलपिंग कंट्रीच्या या प्रॉब्लेममध्ये देर इज वन मोर इश्यू विच इज दॅट वी हॅव मोर डायबिटीज आपल्याकडे जाड लोक नाही आहेत आपल्याकडे श्रीमंती नाही आहे पूर्वी काय कन्सेप्ट होती आपली की डायबिटीज कोणाला होतो हा श्रीमंतांचा आजार आहे हा चीफ एक्झिक्युटिव्ह लोकांचा जे बसून काम करतात त्यांचा आजार आहे तसं आता राहिलेलं नाही आहे आता हा शेतकऱ्यांमध्ये पण दिसतो की जो 24 तास काबाड कष्ट करतोय हा अगदी तुम्ही साध्या स्लम एरियामध्ये गेलात पुण्यामध्ये जो रिसर्च केला केईएमनी त्याच्यामध्ये असं दिसलं की 25% मिडल क्लास पण जवळजवळ 20% स्लम्स मध्ये पण आहे तर ओव्हरऑलच हा आजाराचं स्वरूप आता बदललंय गेल्या 10 वर्षात आणि तो सगळ्यांमध्ये आपल्याकडे फरक असा आहे की भारतीय व्यक्तीला जेव्हा डायबिटीस होतो तो लहान वयात होतो कम्पेअर टू युरोपियन लोकांमध्ये कम्पेअर टू युरोप अमेरिकेतले लोक घेतले आपण व्हाईट कॉकेशियन त्यांच्यापेक्षा 10 वर्ष लवकर येतो आपल्याकडे हार्ट अटॅक जास्त आहेत आपल्याकडे किडनी प्रॉब्लेम जास्त आहेत आणि आपण आपलं सगळ्यात सामर्थ्य काय म्हणतो देशाचं सध्या यंग इंडिया आणि या यंग इंडियाला जर अशा यांनी ग्रासलं तर जितकी रॅपिड इकॉनॉमिक ग्रोथ आहे तितकं जरी इकॉनॉमिक ग्रोथ आपली चांगली असली सध्या नाही पण काही दिवसांनी इंडिया इज वन ऑफ द फ्युचर बघतात सगळं जग त्याच्याकडे ते कोणाच्या जोरावरती आहे तर या यंग इंडियाच्या जोरावर आणि या यंग इंडियाला जर ऍडव्हर्स हेल्थ इफेक्ट झाले तर सगळ्यात जास्त परिणाम सिव्हिअर मध्ये दिसतोय लाल कॅटेगरीमध्ये त्याच्यामध्ये आपला देश आहे सो रॅपिड इकॉनॉमिक ग्रोथ बरोबर जर दिस इज WHO काइंड ऑफ रिडिंग या देशामध्ये जेव्हा जेव्हा हेल्थ डिसीज येतात तर आपल्या देशाच्या याच्यावरती मॅक्झिमम इम्पॅक्ट होऊ शकतो सो आपल्याला अतिशय काळजी घेतला पाहिजे आपल्या मुलांची सुनांची जनरेशनची सो आय एम अराउंड 55 माझ्या आजूबाजूचे जेवढे लोक आहेत तुमच्या लहान वयाच्या जनरेशनला तुम्ही जे काही आज ऐकलं असेल त्याची समरी मी पाठवून देईन पण ती जरूर तुम्ही तुमच्या आतल्या इंटरनल सर्क्युलेशनला शेअर करा यंग जनरेशननी सुधारणं खूप आवश्यक आहे बिकॉज यंग पीपलला डायबिटीस होणं इज नॉट गुड आणि आपलं फ्युचर त्याच्यामध्ये स्टेक आहे रॅपिड अर्बनायझेशन आपण असं म्हणतो पण आजकाल पूर्वी असं म्हणायचे की खेड्यातून लोक शहरात आले आणि म्हणून डायबिटीस झाला आता आजकाल तसं नाहीये, खेड्यांचं शहरीकरण झालंय, लोकांनी शहरात यायची गरज नाहीये, खेडीचंच रूपांतर शहरात झालंय. आता तर इंटरनेटमुळे बोलायलाच नको, आणि वी आर ट्राईंग टू इन्क्रीज इंटरनेट विच इज अगेन आपली मेन रक्तवाहिनी आहे ती भारताची. अनलेस वी हॅव इंटरनेट वी कॅनॉट प्रोग्रेस. इंटरनेटच्या बरोबर अनेक गोष्टी येणार आहेत. सो आता तर छोट्या गावांमधलं शहरीकरण खूप फास्ट होणार आहे, त्याला म्हणतो आपण अर्बनायझेशन. आणि त्याच्याबरोबर येतं पोल्युशन. दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. आपण सगळ्यांनीच बघितलं की 2 महिने जर आपण लॉकडाऊन मध्ये राहिलो पृथ्वी किती स्वच्छ लोकांना, म्हणजे आमच्याकडचा सिंहगड कितीतरी लांबून स्वच्छ दिसायला लागला. मी स्वतः ब्रिजचे फोटो काढले, नदीच्या पात्राचे फोटो काढले पुण्याचे, आणि इट इज शोईंग सो ब्युटिफुल जस्ट विदिन 2 months ऑफ लॉकडाऊन. सो मला तर वाटतं आठवड्यातून 2 दिवस कंपल्सरी लॉकडाऊन कायमचं करावा, म्हणजे आय थिंक आपल्या अनेक गोष्टी स्वच्छ राहतील. आता लोक म्हणतात की हे जेनेटिक आहे का, तर हा प्रश्न सगळ्यांचाच असतो की आमच्या घरात डायबिटीस आहे तर आम्हाला होणार का. तर याचं उत्तर हो पण आहे, पण अजून एक त्यातला एक महत्वाचा प्रश्न मी नंतर सांगते. गेल्या काही पिढ्यांमध्ये जे आपले बदल होत गेले, जेव्हा आपण म्हणतो शहरीकरण, तर आपलं स्वतःचं शहरीकरण असं नसतं, ते आपल्या आधीचे जे आपले पणजोबा होते ते शेती करत होते, मग आजोबा आपले शहरात आले, मग आपण सगळे, आणि आता आपली मुलं पुण्याच्या बाहेर असतात, परदेशी असतात, आणि जास्त इंडस्ट्रीमध्ये असतात. कोकणातला प्रत्येक माणूस मुंबईमध्ये येतो. हा जो लाईफस्टाईल मधला जनरेशनचा फरक आहे, त्याच्याने आजच्या जनरेशनमध्ये पडलंय. मग हे आपण असं म्हणायचं का की माझी तर जीन्स व्हाईटच आहेत, मग मला होणारच, असं नाहीये. तितकीच तुमची लाईफस्टाईल पण जबाबदार आहे. समजा माझ्या आई वडिलांना दोघांना डायबिटीस आहे, तर मला जास्त शक्यता व्हायची, पण जर मी माझी लाईफस्टाईल चांगली ठेवली तर मी हे टाळू शकते. हा त्यातली एक चांगली बातमी आहे. जरी आपण म्हटलं की इट इज जेनेटिक, इट इज लाईफस्टाईल इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. सो जितकं आई वडिलांमध्ये जास्त तेवढं. आता एक नेहमीचा माझ्या सगळ्या लोकांचा प्रश्न असतो की माझ्या 7 पिढ्यात कोणाला डायबिटीस नाहीये, त्यामुळे ते लोक मजेत असतात. म्हणजे युजली हे कॉन्व्हर्सेशन कसं असतं, नवरा बायको येतात आणि मग समजा बायकोला डायबिटीस असेल तर आपण विचारतो घरी कोणाकोणाला आहे, तर मग तो नवरा पटकन म्हणतो आमच्याकडे कोणालाही नाहीये 7 पिढ्यात. किंवा नवऱ्याला असेल तर बायको म्हणते आमच्याकडे कोणालाही नाहीये. या वाक्याला काहीही अर्थ नाही. जरी आपल्या 7 पिढ्यात डायबिटीस नसेल, तर आपण जर भारतीय वंशाचे असू तर आपल्याला डायबिटीस होऊ शकतो. याचं कारण मी जे म्हटलं गेल्या 5 पिढ्यांमध्ये जे बदल होत गेले आपल्या याच्यात, आपल्या जीन्सचं काम बदललं म्हणतात, आणि त्याला एपिजेनेटिक्स असं नाव आहे. सो आपल्या जीन्सचं काम बदललंय, आणि म्हणून भारतीय वंशाच्या लोकांमध्ये डायबिटीसचं प्रमाण हे खूप जास्त आहे. जरी तुमच्या आई वडिलांना डायबिटीस नसला तरी आपल्याला तो 100% व्हायची शक्यता ही भरपूर आहे. हे आपण लक्षात घेऊया, आणि इट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. आता मी काय केलंय, बिकॉज आम्ही सगळे मेडिकल शास्त्रात आम्ही 15-20 मिनिटं बोलायची आम्हाला सवय असते, पण बिकॉज इट्स आपल्याकडे वेळ भरपूर आहे, मी जरा विषय असे वेगळे वेगळे डिवाइड केलेत. आणि आता मी बोलणार आहे व्हॉट इज निग्लेक्टेड डायबिटीस. ज्यांना डायबिटीस आहे त्यांनी हे जरूर ऐका. तुम्हाला वाटेल की मी सांगेन की व्हॉट इज टाईप 1 डायबिटीस, व्हॉट इज टाईप 2 डायबिटीस, मला त्याच्यात जायचंच नाहीये. आपल्याला सगळ्यांना टाईप 2 आहे गृहित धरा. लहान मुलांमध्ये टाईप 1 होतो त्याचं तुम्हाला माहिती असायची गरज नाही. तुम्हाला एकच माहिती पाहिजे की व्हॉट इज निग्लेक्टेड डायबिटीस, हा कुठला प्रकार आहे. निग्लेक्टेड डायबिटीस म्हणजे डायबिटीस आहे माहिती आहे, डॉक्टरकडे पण जाऊन आला, अगदी सगळ्यात मोठ्या डायबिटीस सेंटरकडे मध्ये जाऊन आला तुम्ही, माझ्याकडे पण येतात खूप लोक. एका महिन्यात शुगर उत्तम, HbA1c उत्तम, आणि मग ते विसरून जातात. म्हणजे इतके विसरतात की 1.5 वर्षांनी त्यांना काहीतरी त्रास झाल्यावर ते येतात की एकदम चांगलं होतं मॅडम. म्हटलं हो का, मग काय झालं आता मध्ये शुगर 400 कशी झाली, काय झालं, मी आत्ता तपासली होती एकदम चांगली होती. मग कधी तपासली होती तुम्ही, मग आपण सगळं रेकॉर्ड बघितलं किती वर्षापूर्वी तपासलेली असते. लाईफ इज व्हेरी बिझी आय नो, पण म्हणून स्वतःचा डायबिटीस विसरू नका. कॅलेंडरमध्ये एक कुठली तरी तारीख ठेवा की ज्याच्यामध्ये एव्हरीवन शुड चेक देअर शुगर्स. सो निग्लेक्टेड डायबिटीस इज बॅड. जितके वर्ष तुमची शुगर ही जास्त राहणार आहे, हे जे व्हायलेट कलर दिसतोय तुम्हाला, हा कलर म्हणजे तुमची शुगर तितके दिवस जास्त आहे.
याचा परिणाम 10 वर्षांनी सुद्धा दिसतो. म्हणजे एखादा हा माणूस आहे याची शुगर पहिल्या दिवसापासून उत्तम आहे इथं खाली, ही दुसरी व्यक्ती आहे की त्याची आधी चांगली होती पहिलं वर्ष, मग त्यांनी निग्लेक्ट केलं, निग्लेक्ट करत करत 10 वर्षात तो इतकं वर गेला, मग परत खाली आला, हार्ट अटॅक आला, एंजिओप्लास्टी झाली, एकदम सगळं सुधारलं, ऑइल बंद केलं, शुगर सुधारली, मग त्या दोघांचं सारखं झालं. पण या व्यक्तीमध्ये इतके वर्ष शुगर जास्त राहिल्याने त्याच्या रक्तवाहिन्यांची थोडीशी खराबी होते. सो आपण जे म्हणतो की डायबिटीसची कॉम्प्लिकेशन असतात डोळ्यामध्ये, किडनीमध्ये, पायाच्या नसांमध्ये, काय होतं तर रक्तवाहिन्या खराब होतात. हे तुम्हाला दिसतं इथे, हे असं चोकिंग सुरू होतं रक्तवाहिन्यांचं. आणि मग हे कोणामध्ये जास्त होतं, हे डायबिटीसमुळे होतं का? तुम्हाला असं वाटेल असं काय म्हणतेय मी, तर नाही. कशामुळे होतं? पुअरली कंट्रोल आणि निग्लेक्टेड डायबिटीसमध्ये. जर आपण डायबिटीस उत्तम कंट्रोलमध्ये ठेवला तर आपल्या रक्तवाहिन्या या उत्तम राहू शकतात. ऑल द ब्लड वेसल्स रिमेन क्लीन अँड हेल्दी अँड इलॅस्टिक इफ वी हॅव अवर डायबिटीस अंडर कंट्रोल. इट शुड नॉट बी निग्लेक्टेड. नाव व्हॉट इज युअर आयडिया ऑफ गुड कंट्रोल ऑफ डायबिटीस? यू कॅन सी, जस्ट टू शो यू द पिक्चर, दीज आर द ब्लड वेसल्स अँड दिस इज द अथेरोस्क्लेरोटिक ऑर अ प्लाक, विच यू ऑल नो, यू नो 70% ब्लॉक होता, 90% ब्लॉक होता. सो दीज आर द ऍक्च्युअली ब्लॉक्स. यू कॅन सी दिस इज 90%, दिस इज लेस दॅन 50%, दिस इज क्लीन आर्टरी अँड दिस इज जस्ट अ बिगिनिंग. सो when your diabetes is under control, your blood vessels are absolutely clean and they are elastic. म्हणजे प्रत्येक ठोक्याला with every beat of the heart our blood vessels contract. So what is good control of diabetes? तुम्ही म्हणाल आमची शुगर उत्तम पाहिजे. करेक्ट आहे, उत्तर बरोबर आहे. त्याच्यासाठी घरच्या घरी शुगर करायला लागा. डोंट क्रिटिसाइज ग्लुकोमीटर्स. ऑल ग्लुकोमीटर्स nowadays from good company are good. Control your sugars. What is time in range? 24 hours of the day, if your sugar is in the range, then you are fine, which is not possible. But even though 75% you are under control, you are doing very well. Itka konala shakya nahi hai, pan baryas patients sugar satat jaast aste, which is bad. So tyachyamule jari HbA1c changla asel, aplyala mala mi asa gruhit dharte ki everyone knows what is A1c. A1C is your average control of your glucose, the test which you do every 2 to 3 months, and then it should be below 7%. Even though your A1C is good, your sugar should remain 24 hours under control. माझ्या पुढच्या सगळ्या स्लाइड्स अशासाठी आहेत की त्याच्यामध्ये मी सांगणार आहे की व्हॉट यू शुड डू की तुमची 24 तास शुगर चांगली राहील. आता डायबिटीस कंट्रोलमध्ये जेव्हा आम्ही म्हणतो तेव्हा सगळ्यांना सगळेजण म्हणतात की माझी शुगर उत्तम कंट्रोलमध्ये आहे. पण इट इज नॉट ओनली शुगर. अ गुड कंट्रोल ऑफ डायबिटीसची व्याख्या काय आहे? तर ए म्हणजे शुगर, बी म्हणजे ब्लड प्रेशर, गुड ब्लड प्रेशर कंट्रोल. इट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट इन डायबिटीस. अँड थर्ड इज युअर कोलेस्ट्रॉल. हे ए, बी आणि सी या आपल्या तीन गोष्टी जर उत्तम असतील, युअर A1C, ब्लड प्रेशर अँड कोलेस्ट्रॉल, then your 70-80% complications go down. This is the way. So when I say what is your diabetes under control, you should tell me my LDL cholesterol is below 70, my blood pressure is 130/80, and my A1C is below 7%. Then your diabetes is under control. So sagyani tharva ki I am not going to neglect my diabetes. I will check my sugar, I will keep these under control. Now we will see what is the, how can we avoid or how can we prevent. आपण कॅन वी प्रिव्हेंट ऑल द कॉम्प्लिकेशन्स? येस. कॅन आय अवॉइड डायबिटीस? येस. द आन्सर इज येस. अँड विच इज अगेन लॉट्स ऑफ स्टडीज हॅव डन दॅट यू कॅन पोस्टपोन. सपोज समवन गेट्स गोइंग टू गेट डायबिटीस अँड दे डू गुड लाईफस्टाईल, दे कॅन पोस्टपोन फॉर 10 इयर्स. दॅट इज अगेन इज ऑलमोस्ट लाईक आस्किंग फॉर अन अवॉइडिंग डायबिटीस. नाऊ वी विल सी 4 or 5 पॉइंट्स वेअर we will see what to do. Like काय आपण सहा सात गोष्टी मी घेतल्या आहेत की ज्या तुम्ही करू शकता. 1, to avoid diabetes. Secondly, to avoid complications of diabetes. So let's look at the first point. आपल्या शरीरामध्ये there is a good fat and there is a bad fat. सगळं फॅट वाईट नसतं. काही फॅट आर गुड फॅट, सम आर बॅड फॅट. सो व्हॉट इज बॅड फॅट? ते जर कमी केलं आपण, इफ यू रिड्यूस बॅड फॅट इन युअर बॉडी, यू आर टुवर्ड्स अवॉइडिंग डायबिटीज अँड हार्ट डिसीज. सो व्हॉट इज बॅड फॅट?
I would just want to interrupt you here. The participants are asking you to speak in Hindi instead of Marathi. So it's Hindi and English that they're comfortable.
No issues. So what I was saying, what is bad fat? So bad fat is called as adiposity. Sharir mein, pet ke aju baju mein, jo bhi fat hota hai, which is called as bad fat. So even though someone is obese or someone is thin, they can have more fat in the belly, which is called as bad fat. So if you take a cross section of your abdomen, your tummy, there is a fat in the skin which you can feel when you are touching your abdomen, but there is also fat inside the viscera, which is around kidneys, around liver, around pancreas, around heart. This is called as bad fat, or we call it as a central adiposity. And this bad fat is extremely dangerous inner visceral fat, which is proportionate to your abdominal circumference. So if you measure your abdomen, if it is more than 95 cm, it is bad. Achha nahi hai. Pet hona, it is not good. It's not, though it's a sign of wealth, it is not a sign of health. Okay, so this is actually bad fat inside the abdomen. And what is it? It is related to blood pressure, related to diabetes, and related to your cholesterol and heart disease. So more the bad fat in the abdomen, it is bad. So you need to reduce this. We will see how to reduce our visceral adiposity so that your abdomen circumference should go down, which can be done by exercise and diet. We'll come to that. There is another fat. If you take your general fat in the muscles, which is around the muscles, there is a brown fat and white fat. So if you do a lot of exercise, your brown fat gets converted to muscles and your insulin action improves and everything improves. Your lifestyle change. So even though you are doing lifestyle change, you should know what is it getting changed. So is my abdomen tummy going down? Am I losing weight? All these are questions you need to ask. A simple weight loss, even though you lose 1 kg, you are going to lose lot of bad fat, so which is very important. So small amount of weight loss, suppose you are 60 and you lose 1 or 2 kg, even a modest kind of a weight loss have lot of beneficial effects. Your insulin starts working, your cholesterol goes down, your blood pressure improves. There are lot of good things with the even smallest kind of a weight loss. So weight loss as well as vigorous activity, both together will reduce lot of things. So what I said in my first point is that you need to lose weight if you are overweight, or agar weight bhi hai to pet kam karna bahut zaruri hai. The abdomen has to go down so that aap mein se jo bad fat hai pet mein wo kam hoga. So modest weight loss and visceral adiposity, this was my first thing. Whenever whatever lifestyle change we are thinking, it should go down. Now second is exercise. Everyone knows a lot about exercise, and during lockdown period I hope everyone has read and seen a lot about exercise on your internet. So but still I will like to give you something. So exercise and activity, these are two different things which I want to stress. Exercise, what you do, like 1 hour you go for brisk walk or you do running or cycling. And activity is what you are doing in day to day life every hour, like you are working in the home, in the kitchens, or you are cleaning your home, or you are working in a factory where you need to walk, or you are on the field, maybe in your agriculture department, or maybe big factories where you are producing. You continuously walk. That is called as activity during work. And exercise is what you do for your routine fitness. So sedentary lifestyle is very bad. This is not the way to go for a walk. You can see this person is going in the morning because his dog needs a walk. You know all these, and dog lovers, they really do this, and this really happens. I have seen in Pune, people are on two-wheeler and they take their dogs.
for a walk in the morning. Why can't you just run with the dog? You are losing a good opportunity to do a good exercise, which is compulsory with your partner, who is your doggy best friend. So don't do this. If you have a pet animals, of course, you should walk. You see, this is a gym and a fitness, and you can see everyone is going in the gym. You can see in the gym attire with the napkin and a water bottle, but they all are using escalators. This is, I mean, by activity. If you are going to the gym, you should take stairs. You are not supposed to go on escalator there. So everywhere in Mumbai, people are very active. Compared to Pune, it's extremely active. I say you walk more, you climb the stairs more. Wherever possible, don't take escalators. That's the picture which I want to show. And what is this picture? This is our diabetes conference, international. I have taken, I think, somewhere in the picture. There's you all know, there's a huge expo they build, and they have huge escalators where you can go 3 floors up. But no one is using stairs. Only one gentleman, but that is also coming down. Everyone, all these are specialized diabetes doctors across the world who are like me and giving teachings to everyone. But when it comes to their lifestyle, they are also taking escalators. So this is bad. That's what I want to show. This is not good. So what are the exercises? There are 3 types of exercises. One is running, cycling, a very good exercise, stretching or gym, again a very good exercise, like a stretching during yoga, and a swimming, which actually combines a lot of. So there are different types of exercises which are important. People say, no, I go to the gym. Some say, no, I go only for a walk. So which is not good. Walking is aerobic, but you have to combine it with resistance training exercises. What is resistance training? A kind of a gym where your muscle groups work. So you have to have, I will say, twice gym and at least. So if you combine, then there is a more benefit. Like this is, these are individuals who do not want diabetes. So this is a scientific exercise. You must have heard that by doing some special diet, there is a reversal of diabetes. Everyone knows about this. There is a lot going on the internet. But that is only calorie restriction, which is not good. Just reducing calories, your sugars will go down, no doubt. So these are the individuals where you can see their weight went down. The black bars are those who are doing only dieting. And the white bars are those who are doing dieting plus resistance training exercises. Both lose weight, both lose fat, but you can see those who are doing exercise, they are losing fat more or weight more. And what is more important? Strength. Muscle strength is increasing in the person who is doing both diet plus exercise. This is going to improve the insulin action and actually going to postpone diabetes. If you do only diet, once you stop it, within 6 months, you get all the bad things back. So do together. So what is the message? When you're doing dieting, you do a combination of diet, less eating, along with exercise, you will be in the best of this combination. These are the individuals who are doing very good. So everyone should have a prescription, whether I should walk, can I do running? Can I do marathon? Can I climb the hill? Can I cycle for 1 hour? Can I go to the gym? What about swimming? All these things you should discuss with your doctor. But it's not like once you have diabetes, you cannot run marathon. You can run marathon. So you should know what exercise you can do. More the exercise, more is the dose, more is the response. Now I will come to the... So this is a must. And I hope we also get to do all these things once the lockdown gets over. We are really dying to do outdoor exercises, but at present we need to do indoor or wherever possible. Now, this is the saying that it is not diabetes, heart disease and obesity runs in your family, but it is that no one is running in your family. So this is just a kind of a humor. If everyone is running in your family, diabetes will not run in your family. So I think it's a very nice sentence. I like it very much. Now, third point is exercise when you are working. Like you are sitting. Nowadays, sitting in front of a computer, laptop is a new norm of life. Even school, going to the school, running, everything we have forgotten. Everyone is in front of the laptops. Work from home is the culture. So here I will like to show, if you interrupt the sitting, see the benefits we are getting. So these guys are just sitting, and these guys, there was a research done. What they did, 5 minutes of a walking, when you are like, I'm talking to you, I stand up and I just do some kind of exercise and I again sit down. So what I did, I just interrupted my sitting. So when you're getting up from the chair and doing some kind of a normal kind of, even though you're talking, you can do simple jogging. If you interrupt your sitting, see the advantage. Your weight goes down, your abdominal obesity goes down, पेट का घेर कम हो जाता है, sugar improve होता है, and you can actually help in avoiding diabetes. So again, so I think there is now some, after this serious dose, I want to take you to the Europe. We always say Europeans do not have diabetes and they do not have a heart attacks. And you must have read loads of articles. It is because they have a beautiful lifestyle. This is, of course, from a typical Europe summertime. Everyone is outside having beer or wine. And everyone says the wine is helping them. And that's why they do not have a heart attack. And you will see loads of literature that how wine helps. Maybe, but this is not European lifestyle. If you stay there for a month or two, you will see what is their lifestyle. These are the pictures taken by myself. I have taken these photographs when I was in Amsterdam. See the cycle stands. See this lady. Her age is more than 60. Though she is obese, she's daily they do cycling. Every day they do 10 to 20 kilometers cycling. See this couple. They have 2 children. There is a children are sitting in front of the cycle and they are doing cycling. They do cycling so much, and it is very impressive. See the cycle stands. Once upon a time in Pune, there was like this when I was in college. I used to cycle almost 10 kilometers to go to Ferguson College. Now nothing happens. So this is European lifestyle. You go any city in the Europe, they walk a lot. Every day they commute to the workplace. This lady was in my train. She will get down at the station, put 2 children to the school, and then she will go to her workplace, finish her work, go back, carry the children, go back. So this is the lifestyle. Pune also had something. So we always talk about their wine and the beer and their sitting, and they have good genes. We say Europeans have good genes, but if you see, the lifestyle is actually, they are very much, they really take weekends off. The idea or concept of spending a weekend is to go for a hike or go for running or do some exercise, which in India we do not have at all. So let's not blame our genes. Let's change our concept of weekends or an everyday thing and follow the European lifestyle by means not having kind of a wine, but increasing more kind of a physical activity. And these all pictures I have taken myself. These are not from the internet. And I'm really intrigued by these people's lifestyle. So just 2-3 points more. Stress management, I'm not going to go into the details because there are a lot of gurus who are there. Only one very important message I want to give, Ramdev Baba, whom people thought about stress management and Zika and whatever deep breathing exercises, all of you do. TV ke saamne ke baithe, hum 45 minute pranayam karte hain. 45 minute hum yoga karte hain. But kaise karte hain yoga? Ramdev Baba is doing on front of TV and you are doing. That is not. If you see daily lifestyle of Ramdev Baba, he gets up early in the morning and he runs 1 hour. He does 2 hours of exercises. Then he runs to the stage where he is taking your classes. Before that, he does 3 hours of physical exercise. Plus in the evening, he plays on the football or basketball ground. That is his lifestyle. That's why he is so fit and he can do Bhastrika so great. So what I want to say, physical exercise is very important to reduce mental stress. 1 hour brisk walk is the best way to reduce mental stress. Plus, I will definitely have few good lines about breathing exercises and meditation. No doubt this is important, but this is an additional exercise. After your 1 hour of exercise, you can spend 15, 20 minutes, 30 minutes into this. It will calm. It will reduce your blood pressure. It will reduce your heart rate. It will improve a lot of things in the body. But after, if you are not doing exercises, physical and you are doing only this, it will not help you. So always, I think Ramdev Baba is the best example. He is extremely physically fit and he is teaching you how to do meditation and exercises. Inspiration, expiration and Bhastrika, which is actually a diaphragmatic breathing. So your diaphragm moves, which is very good to reduce that bad fat as well as improve heart. So this was about stress management. So this is just a joke. You will think, but this is not a joke. There is a lot of research going on to have an exercise pill, which will improve things automatically. Just two slides about, this is very important. Smoking actually kills your beta cells of pancreas. It, wo to sab hai hi, matlab so smoking will increase cancer, smoking will increase heart attack. But for diabetes, it actually kills the beta cells. So smoking is bad. So stop smoking. You can see these pictures. These are very good pictures to watch and see. Very stylish. Lot of good faces here. Everyone will love to watch these pictures, but do not smoke. So my saying is, please stop smoking. Even one cigarette will take away all the good things which you are doing. So no smoking. There is no concession in that. Even same is true about tobacco. Few words about alcohol, we will come into question answers, but there are good wine which are true, but to get those polyphenols, you need to have a bad effects of alcohol also. So it is better you know polyphenols, you can take them from actually anardana or pomegranate. This is rich of polyphenols. So you don't have to have grapes or wine for that. The pomegranate, passion fruit, all these are dragon fruit, are very good examples of best polyphenols. Now we call sugar is the next tobacco. Why? Because eating too much of sugar is bad. So people will say, I do not have diabetes. No one in my family has diabetes. My 7th generation, no one has diabetes. What is the problem if I eat sweet? No, you cannot eat. If you are from Indian origin, please remember, sugar is the next tobacco. Try to control eating sugar. So what we call it, Bhagwan ka diya hua khao, halwai ka mat khao. So avoid food. You can have natural fruits, which are good. Like honey. Honey is good, though it is sugar. It has lot of vitamin C. That doesn't mean a diabetes person can eat lots of honey. No, it will increase its sugar. But it's a kind of a healthy. So that's why again I am repeating, halwai sugar is bad. So sugar is the next tobacco. And there's lots and lots of research which actually decreases pancreas function. So please avoid sugar. It is not good. I don't know you are related to how much sugar industry, though you are agriculture, but sugar is bad for the health. Even though you do not have diabetes. So please remember that. It is the sugar, we call it as a next tobacco. It's almost like as bad as smoking. Okay, now I'm not going into the diet in detail. Just few words that you should have healthy food. And now you know, even though you do not have junk food, you survive during lockdown. You feel good. All my patients' sugar have improved because the outside food is stopped. They are not eating outside food. So fried food is bad. So if you are eating in your canteens, then you need to, though it tastes nice or gives, you should not eat a fried food. And it should replace with the healthy food habits. So lots of salads. I will come to that. I have two slides about how, why these healthy food, what it does. Like having a food like eggs, or chicken or fish is a healthy food. Lots of vegetables in the diet is a healthy food, and also the fruits. So these are the healthy food habits. All oils are not bad. Some oils are good, but don't heat the oil. So they say Mediterranean diet is good, but this is equal to the Indian Mediterranean diet. You can lots of sprouts every day. Carry your dabba of a small dabba with as only sprouts. Carry like buttermilk, have these kind of zavas and the nuts. If you are eating every day, these are all scientific studies. I am not just showing what people are general pictures. It is shown that if you eat 35 grams of nuts every day, your heart attack risk goes down. Your diabetes risk goes down. So it is a kind of a good food. So this, even a kind of a ghee, which is made from the cow's milk, one teaspoonful every day is good. So super foods like broccoli and everything. So try to have healthy food habits every day. So my last point is about gut microbiome. So have you heard about microbiome? These are the bacteria which we live. Right from the birth, whenever a baby is born, his intestines are get colonized with bacteria within hours. So our intestine is full of bacteria. These bacteria are more than our normal cells. So what we call them as a organ. So you have liver, जैसे liver होता है, pancreas होता है, heart होता है, kidney होता है शरीर में, और इन सब का काम हमारे लिए बहुत जरूरी होता है. Similarly, gut microbiome is an organ which actually is very important to the body. It creates energy homeostasis. It is you all are talking about immune boosters. Everyone is saying ye khao wo khao ye boli lo ye, you do this so that your immunity will improve. How your immunity will, who decides? The your gut bacteria in our gut decide our immunity. They are extremely important in the immune system regulation. They are very important in giving vitamins to us and micronutrients. So microbiome are two types. One are good microbiota, good bacteria, and one are bad bacteria. If you eat bad food, the bad bacteria go up. So what it was, a large study published in 2020 in China, what it showed that the people with diabetes have more bad bacteria in their gut and there are good bacteria are less. So, and what is the good news? Let me tell you. So this is like diabetes people, they have less good, the combination is bad. So the more bad bacteria go up, your heart and diabetes risk goes up. So these gut microbiota, within 18 hours, you can see this, I don't know if you can read this, just within one day or 18 hours or maybe 5 or 6 days, if we change our diet, our good bacteria improve. So there are a lot of good things, like if I will talk about some food which improve good bacteria, and these are the good bacteria which are going to improve our immunity. They are going to decrease our glucose. They are going to decrease the bad fat, which I was talking all about. So how can I improve my good bacteria? How can I? So first thing, I have to eat good food. The first good food for all these bacteria is fiber. Like the fiber which comes from your salads or the green vegetables which are rampant. Aajkal jo mil raha hai, shravan, geoda, gawar, bhindi. All these kind of vegetables have a lot of fiber. So whenever the fiber, soluble or insoluble, is more in your diet, your good bacteria improve. The good bacteria will improve your immune system. They will improve your vitamins. They will improve the glucose. Even good sleep, good 8-hour sleep will improve microbiota. So these bacteria have a connection from our intestines to our brain. And even the feeling that I'm hungry, I want to eat more, comes from these bacteria. If you have a good fiber in your diet, these bacteria secrete GLP-1. The GLP-1 goes to the brain and tells that it is full, I don't need more food. So that feeling that I don't want to eat comes from GLP-1. GLP-1 comes from the gut when there is a more of a good bacteria. So have this concept very clearly. If you have fried food, the bad bacteria go up. And then the GLP goes down. All the bad effects on the health happens through this. So we have to take care of gut microbiome. They are helping us so much. These gut microbiome are helping us so much. They are keeping us active. They are keeping us away from diseases. So what we should do, we should help them. We should give them good food so that they are healthy. As you take care of your pet dogs or a pet cat, how much you take care of them? Similarly, these are the microbiome inside our body. We need to take care of them. Give them good food. Give them good fiber so that they will take care of us. So this concept is very important. And if you think like buttermilk, it's extremely good for this microbiome. curd. It is very good. So all healthy food habits will improve your good microbiome. And this is the, I think I wanted to give as a, just if you eat lot of fried food and then you have something good for like honey or some good for microbiota, it is of no use. Already bad bacteria are more. So please do exercise and sleep, improve good microbiome. Now last point, educate yourself. In India, the knowledge which you seek by education, by having PhDs, the big ministers, big vice chancellors of university with 8 degrees have extremely poor knowledge about health. So health knowledge, which that's why I congratulated when Mr. Sonode talked to me or your team of your organization who is arranging these lectures. Health knowledge is crucial, and which everyone should. People don't know what is protein, what is carbohydrates. This is wrong. So I am happy that education is changing. So what is protein? We need to educate ourselves. So big congratulations to you. And my please, at least whatever you have learned today, tell 5 other people who were not listening to today's lecture that what you learned. These 8 points about exercise, not sitting for the prolonged time, taking care of microbiome, then taking care of your sugar, blood pressure, A1C, everything. So whatever you learn, please remember. And it's a teamwork. Suppose one person in the family decides, I want to be healthy today. It is not possible if your whole family is not together. Your friends, are kai nahi hot rahe, take 2 more jalebi. Ye lo aur 5 le lo. So it's a teamwork. It's your friends, your family, your society, and your work culture should go towards more kind of a healthy lifestyle. Then only you get the World Cup or whatever the present for the things. So through our Shailaja guys, like my name, Diabetes and Specialty Clinics, we arrange these lectures for 30 years in Pune. So many years, like I started from a small hall, but now even Ganesh, this is Ganesh Kala Krida Manch, and this is Tilak Smarak Mandir. This Vapu Kale was my friend, Shanta Shelke used to be with me for all my lectures. Everyone knows Colonel Lalit Rai. Recently we celebrated Kargil. He was one important Colonel Lalit Rai from there. He educated our people, and now this education, which I used to take so much efforts, it's very easy for me now because of the digital platforms. Otherwise, aap sab kahan aate mere lecture ko Pune mein. So I'm very happy that I am doing through digital platform to teach you about a good way of lifestyle, which I have done for so many years. And I continue to do it like this. We take these educator courses, we teach, and we also do our YouTube channel and our Facebook page by Dr. Shailaja Kale's Diabetes and Specialty Clinic. So please visit our subscribe to YouTube channel. Every week you will be getting these kind of small lectures or the small videos which will educate. I think the dose of today was too much. 45 minutes I am talking. I think it was too much. Just we will repeat what we discussed, that take care of your microbiota, do exercise very regularly, interrupt your sitting, prolonged sitting. Having active lifestyle 24 hours is best. Even exercise, if you do 3 times a day, it is better than 1 hour exercise. So exercise, you need to concentrate. Healthy food habits, stress management, no smoking, look at sugar as a tobacco. I think these are the points you need to remember to have a change your lifestyle and have a healthy lifestyle. So thank you so much for listening to me for such a long time.
Thank you, Dr. Shailaja.
Yes.
Everyone can ask questions now in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself and ask questions if you have any.
चलो गरम करून आणूया. आता मी इशर झालंय, तुला बाहेर काम असेल तर गेलीस तर. सॉरी, आय एम नॉट फाइन. इट हॅपन्स.
Madam, I want to ask one question, that if a person is having a lifestyle which is sedentary, means he has to sit every time in office and his lifestyle is sedentary, he does his exercises, in the for half an hour, evening half an hour. But he's sedentary when he's in the office because he has the work related to his PC only. So in that case, what are the means advantages and disadvantages? Can you guide us?
Yes, there are no advantages. There are only disadvantages of a sitting lifestyle. So that's why I showed you. So what you should do, you stand up in between. Every 1 hour you interrupt, every 30 minutes you interrupt your sitting. You can just stand. Even simple standing increases calorie burning. Or you can just do like kind of a marching at that point. Or you can just walk for some steps, which you do for 3 to 5 minutes. I'm not saying 30 minutes. Every 30 minutes or every 1 hour, if you do 3 to 5 minutes breaking of your sitting, then it helps. Even in the night time, your sugar and blood pressure goes down. So this is very important for young generation. And nowadays, everyone, because everyone is working from home, but especially young people, even though they are not working, they will be on their phone, WhatsApps and all the entertainment and very important tasks they are doing, but it is on the phone. So we need to remember this. So interrupt the sitting. So sedentary lifestyle is you need to interrupt that. Plus exercise twice a day is very good what you said. So get up, walk, stand, do marching at that place, do simple kind of things in between.
Now it is said that, lifespan has increased. Lifespan has increased. Earlier it was 60, then it was 70. Now it is above the average. But still the different thing is that the people who are young, they are getting diabetes and all those things. So when they are working, any important tips you want to give them apart from whatever you have said? Because what happens at the age of 33, 35 and up to 40 also people start getting diabetes. Earlier this stage was not like that. It was like that after 40, फिर जाके sugar check करो, फिर देखो आया कि नहीं, तो 60, 50 के बाद ही होता था diabetes. But now in young generation people also, we find people diabetic and they perceive their diabetes and when their circumstances become difficult, then they start their treatment. So this becomes a problem.
No, you are absolutely right. Not only young people, children are getting diabetes, type 2 diabetes, children. Because lot of schools do not have playgrounds. Abhi to school hi nahi hai, but phir bhi schools do not have playgrounds. They are not playing, they are sitting. So for young people is to have more, I won't go more, okay, diet you know, but what I want to stress here is physical exercise. All kind of physical exercise, Saturday, Sunday, more physical activity. So those who are in 35, 40, they should start doing this jogging, running. Take your children with you and go for a hiking or do something. Another important thing is test, checkup karo. Go and laboratories and check every year. That is very important. Okay, bolo.
How much is hereditary important in this? Hereditary factor is important in for this getting a diabetes.
A person who is
35 years, his father is diabetic, and one person who is 35 years, his parents' history is not diabetic. So, can you compare both of them and help me out?
Yes. So, as I said, if you are hereditary, if your parents are diabetic, definitely your chance of getting diabetes is much more. But at the same time, you can avoid it by good healthy lifestyle. And even though your parents do not have diabetes, you can get diabetes. So, if your parents are having diabetes, maybe from the school age only, the parents should insist for more kind of a healthy lifestyle for the children. And please start checking the blood reports after 25 years of age, every year. So that if you diagnose early, it is good. I have so many of young people, 35, 32, 29, they get diabetes. Just out of college, 2 years of some good software job and they come with diabetes. So checkup is important. So that's what I'm saying when your children are kids. If they see you exercising every day, they follow that. So change Thanks. Your home culture.
Good evening, Thanks, Madam Nimbalkar speaking. May I want to know, Madam, the exercise, the lot of persons say that we are working in office every day standing and walking here and there. The lot of work doing on workplace. But the early morning or evening time is good for exercise. The prevention of diabetes is good or bad?
No, there is no particular time. You can do exercise any time of the day. It is helpful. But as I said, separate 1 hour exercise in a day is very good. One, maybe 2 hours. Morning 1 hour, evening 1 hour. Apart from your activity during office time. So maybe you are active in your office, you are walking, but a 1 hour exercise in the morning and additional 1 hour in the evening is extremely crucial. Now, whether to do early morning, if you can't get up, if you don't have time, you have to catch the local, you have to go to the office by having a bus, or there is a lot of commute, you can do it in the evening. You can do it in the lunchtime.
Madam, what I am saying, that a lot of ladies say that we are doing the lot of work in kitchen. So this is the exercise or is the routine work? Doing the exercise, when you are doing the exercise, you may be mentally free.
Okay, now that is, it's a good point you are asking. So what your question is, if you are doing only exercise in, like you are focusing on exercise, you are mentally free and it helps you more. You are absolutely right. That actually takes away your stress. But to your question, when there the homework is different, like in the kitchen, there is not much physical work. It's you are doing things like that. You are mostly standing. But when you start doing the whole homework, which everyone was doing during lockdown, cleaning, sweeping, changing bed covers, it's a good physical activity. All my patients' sugars came down. Within 1 month of lockdown, the sugar started dropping. So doing only kitchen work is not. One has to do all the work in the home. Then it is a good kind of activity. But your point is right. Even though they are working in kitchen, additional 1 hour exercise is a must. Because no one does the full work as they were doing in lockdown. It is rare otherwise. Now people who help us in home kind things, they have started coming back. So additional 1 hour separate exercises is always good.
Ma'am, we have some questions on the chat also. So the first question is type 1 diabetes curable?
No.
It's not.
I don't want to go into details. No.
Okay. How to test?
All type 1 children need insulin throughout their life. Insulin is their oxygen. If you try to go to some other doctors or some other pathy, Ayurveda or something for stopping insulin, you are killing that child. So type 1 diabetes, insulin is a must. So no questions about that. Okay, then I can read the questions actually. You want to read?
Okay, so the next question is how to test sugar at home?
Yeah, I think all glucometers are good. They are calibrated. All good companies glucometer. You can check anytime. Do fasting or any random sugar if it is more than 180. If you do not have diabetes, then it is bad. Anything fasting above 100 is bad. So, agar aap pehli dafa kar rahe hain aur aapka sugar zyada dikhta hai, to please go to the laboratory and check it. If you have diabetes, then check it at particular time, jaise bagair khaye piye fasting. फिर खाने के बाद 2 घंटे के बाद विच कैन बी आफ्टर ब्रेकफास्ट कैन बी आफ्टर लंच और कैन बी आफ्टर डिनर सो चेक इट एट होम इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट
द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज कैन यू लेट अस नो अबाउट सम मोर इंग्रेडिएंट्स फॉर द गट
ओह इट्स अ बिग टॉपिक इट्स अ टॉपिक फॉर 1 आवर सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज मोर फाइबर कोकोनट इज गुड देन देयर आर लॉट ऑफ फ्रूट्स विद द स्किन is very good. All fruits with a lot of seeds is good. Nuts, you know, akrod and badam, these are good. All berries, zambal, these kind of fruits are very good. There are a lot of food which are good, which has a lot of fiber. Like if you are having a polished rice, it is bad. But if you are having a rice which is there directly from the farm, it is a better kind of a rice, something like that. I think there is a question about which cereal is good. Someone has asked.
The last question, which cereal is better, wheat, rice, sorghum, millets or ragi?
Every serial has some good and some the composition is different. But if you take standard in India, what we eat, rice, chapati, and bhakri. So all three have bad glycemic index. All three are same in increasing your sugar. Jwari bajri will also increase your sugar. Chapati will also increase your sugar. But more polished is the cereal like gehu and rice. It is bad. Unpolished rice or boiled rice which you get or these kind of rice is better. But overall, you need to cut down the cereal intake. Like your chapati, rice and bhakri, you should decrease, or bread, you should decrease and increase the other parts like dal and the vegetables and the salads in your plate. In the plate, 50% should be only salads and dal and everything. 25% you can have proteins or something, and your portion of chapati rice should reduce.
The next question is free insulin in our body determined or can be determined or tested?
Lot of people check insulin levels. There is no point in checking insulin levels if you already have a diabetes. You should not check insulin levels. If you want to know how much your pancreas are producing insulin, there are tests which are done like C-peptide or a ratio of fasting sugar, C-peptide, insulin, which decides how much your pancreas are producing insulin. You can't check insulin levels. That's different. So checking insulin has no meaning, except in some instances when someone doesn't have diabetes, like obesity or young girls with polycystic ovarian, there's some diseases. But overall, there is no point in checking insulin. There are other ways to see how your pancreas are working.
How much medicine helps Amaryl Felicita OD?
Okay, now I want to say only one sentence here. All medicines of diabetes are very good. All medicines may work. One tablet may work for one person. It may not work for other person. That doesn't mean that tablet is or that medicine is bad. All medicines are good. Which works for you is to be decided by your doctor and yourself by some experiments. Okay. Every tablet has some side effects of diabetes. You have to discuss these side effects, and no diabetic medicine damages your kidney or heart. That's a wrong concept. All are very safe drugs, but little bit like diarrhea, nausea. These things may happen, constipation. So you have to discuss. All medicines are good, but whether they are acting for you is between you and your doctor.
Nowadays, Dixit diet is popular. Whether it works for diabetic?
See, Dixit diet is intermittent fasting. So I don't want to go into the details of Dixit diet, but if you are not eating for a long time, it is good for your microbiome, which I discussed. So fasting actually improves our microbiota. So our system of culture that one day you do fast is very good. If you do fasting for 1 month, it is bad. Like continuous full fasting. So kind of a fasting is good. Dixit is eating twice a day, which is good. Why not? But don't eat too much that time. If you eat everything for a diabetic person, your postprandial glucose goes up, A1C goes up. So there is nothing wrong in Dixit diet. You can change your medicines, but don't eat everything. Like I'm doing Dixit diet, I can do vada pav, main ye bhi kha sakta hu, wo bhi kha sakta hu, aisa nahi hai. If you are doing this, still you need to follow of a healthy food rules, even though you are doing Dixit diet. It is good. Jitna kam khaoge, utna achha hai. So, agar aap do baar kha rahe, I am very happy. Instead of three, just skip the breakfast. I have only two, lunch and dinner.
Eating one spoon methi dana daily, whether it is good to control sugar?
There are lots of things. There are so many things. You eat this, eat that. There are a lot of good things in these herbal. We call it's herbal medicines. The thoughts came from Ayurveda. And everything like jambul powder, the jamuns are good, methi dana is good. It's not bad, but if you are getting side effects of methi seeds, don't eat. It is not bad. It has good, like dalchini has good effect. Methi dana has good effect. Tea is very good antioxidant. The tea tea which is black tea, not the tea which we take with milk and sugar. A black tea is very good. So there are a lot of good effects of these antioxidant kind of things.
Ma'am, there is one more question. Is it necessary to give statin and blood thinner in diabetic management for 50 plus age?
Yes. Blood thinners is decided by the heart risk. But never stop your blood thinners if your doctor has advised, like aspirin. It is important. It has shown to decrease mortality. And also statins, they help a lot in reducing heart attacks and the brain attacks. So it is it helps in diabetes. As I was saying, A, B, C. The C is cholesterol is taken care by statins.
Okay.
Eating oil is required to change frequently.
Yes. So all oils have some good. So the system of changing oil in the home is very good. So you know, the one are seed oils and one are plant oils. So you need to change these oils frequently at home, but a portion amount should be less.
Is juice of Karela or bitter gourd helping in diabetes control?
I was a part of Kerala tablets research, and Kerala tablet hasn't shown anything. But as I said, like having jamuns or a methi dana or a Kerala, these are kind of have some effect, some good effect. So, but it's not, it hasn't shown in scientific studies very good results. So you don't have to, but a little bit of juice, rather than juice, I recommend eating vegetables. Like people nowadays take a lot of juice of vegetables, like from the gourd or carrots, beetroot. You eat that. Don't take juice. You are removing the fiber, the most important part, which is going to help your microbiome. So you can eat these vegetables. Kerala juice, as a healthy habit, you can have a little bit. It's not, it doesn't do harm. I don't know about the whole thing.
Anyone has any other questions?
Are there any more questions? You can directly ask them by...
Okay.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello, madam. आवाज येतोय का?
येतो
बोल. मला काय विचारायचं आहे, एक सर्वसाधारण असं म्हणजे असं बोलतो आपण शरीराला साखर पण आवश्यक आहे, तर किती पर्यंत ती पाहिजे, म्हणजे धोकादायक कितीच्या पुढे नको? सगळं 300-400 तुम्ही मगाशी म्हणाला 400 पण खूप आहे. एका ठिकाणी असं वाचलं म्हणजे व्हॉट्सअपच्या आपल्या संशोधनातून की फॉरेनला काही जण म्हणतात की 200 वरती 200 खाली जर असेल तर नॉर्मल
समजतात.
काय सांगता येईल?
नाही नाही. सो व्हॉट यू आर आस्किंग, पूछ रहे की व्हॉट इज द नॉर्मल. सो नॉर्मल ग्लुकोज लेवल इज डिफाइंड बाय लॅबोरेटरीज, यू नो दॅट. सो फास्टिंग अबाउ 90 इज बॅड, और खाने के बाद का अबाउ 140 इज बॅड, अँड एच बी ए वन सी अबाउ 6 इज बॅड. दॅट मीन्स यू हॅव डायबिटीज. सो इसके नीचे शुगर चाहिए. युअर फर्स्ट सेंटेन्स था की शरीर के लिए शुगर इज इम्पॉर्टंट, विच इज करेक्ट. But not sugar, which you eat sugar. Whatever you eat, chapati, bajri, bakri, vegetables, rice, everything you get converted into glucose. So that's how you are getting glucose. Your body is getting glucose from all the food. You don't need to eat sugar.
Prolonged use of diabetic drug metformin has any effect on body? Adverse
effect? Ma'am, there is a question. That is, does the prolonged mix dietary drug metformin has any effect on the body if it is being used for a longer time?
No, metformin can be used all your life, no problem. Only thing, if someone has got some problems, in some patients we don't use metformin. That doctor decides. But otherwise, if metformin is only problem is loose motions, which happens 1 in 1,000. So someone can get diarrhea, then we have to stop the drug. And there are some conditions where we don't use metformin, which doctors know.
Okay, fine. I think Dr. Kai, the session has been very informative, and you like to thank you because you made our participants really aware that this can be reversible with the lifestyle modification, and if one takes this seriously, we can prolong it or at the same time even ensure that this doesn't happen to anybody. So emphasizing on this lifestyle modification was a very apt thing for this session. So thank you very much, and thank you to all the participants, their family members, senior dignitaries who have attended this session, for attending this webinar. And as we said earlier, that CMDC looks forward for providing such kind of inputs to all employees, which enhances their productivity and enhances their healthy well-being. We will be making this YouTube, and this will be available for all our employees on our RCF intranet. So, Dr. Kare, thank you very much for facilitating us on this very important topic. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.